My passion for the ocean and for the art has come from growing up in Jamaica and having parents who were very outdoorsy. It made an indelible mark and a huge impression on me. My name is Guy Harvey and I'm chairman of the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation and of Guy Harvey Enterprises. Art has now become more of an educational tool for me. Apart from being aesthetically pleasing, you can construct and tell the story of a little part of the life history of the animal that you're painting. Over the last two decades, we've spent a lot of time and money and effort learning more about the billfishes, the tunas, and the sharks. Many species of sharks face very few natural threats, but introduce the human factor, fishing, and the shark fin trade, and all of a sudden you've got a problem.
So at the Guy Harvey Research Institute, we study a variety of biological features and aspects of typically big fish. You have to understand the animals and how they work in order to plan and implement better conservation measures. If you don't know what they do, how are you going to conserve them? So one of the studies that the Guy Harvey Research Institute is doing is what is called migration ecology of a variety of species, but including quite recently actually, whale sharks. And this program involves putting satellite tags on whale sharks to see how these migratory pathways are interacting with, for example, shipping lanes. How these migratory pathways are interacting with where people are drilling for oil. And if we know that information, we can advise governments, and even oil companies for that matter, to say that these are really critical pathways, which also means habitats for these endangered species. We're able to take these locations of these animals in near real time using these types of tags. So Milo went well out into the Atlantic and came back. Rio Lady went south into the Caribbean and came back, and then into the northern Gulf of Mexico. Lucho is another animal. Lucho has spent a little bit of time in the Caribbean, crossed over into the Atlantic a little bit, and then went back into the Gulf of Mexico. So the Gulf of Mexico is a good place for them. Clearly, they're all doing that. They're spending some of their time in the Gulf of Mexico, right? But when they are outside of the Gulf of Mexico, in the Caribbean and the Atlantic, they seem to have very different patterns. We need to keep these animals around. And the best way to do that is to learn more and more about them and then implement that into conservation efforts, into protection efforts, so that they don't go extinct.
The oceans are very resilient. In spite of our overexploitation of all marine resources, with better management, better science, better conservation, they will bounce back, and they can bounce back really quickly. I feel our generation has not done a really good job in terms of looking after marine resources. We are responsible for most of the exploitation that's taken place. And so it's really encouraging to see millennials and the newer generations take an active interest in things around them and learn about the issues and participate and speak out. And it's really encouraging to see that there is a change happening soon.